Cheers.
I saw my baby walking.
Keep an eye out for Mickey Mouse. We don't want to run him over.
Young lady, the little one with you?
Yeah, he's buried in there someplace. It was a long drive, he's fast asleep.
Let me give you a key so you can unpack some.
Thank you.
You need any help?
Oh, no, thank you. I don't have much.
Okay, if you need anything, just let me know. You've got the number.
I do, Mr. Langtree, thank you.
What is this place?
It's your new home.
Huh?
Isn't it wonderful? It's like a dream. How lucky are we?
Cody, look at your room.
Such fun wallpaper, huh?
Oh, and this desk. It's perfect. You can do all of your homework right here.
It's just so great, huh? Oh, lots of space out there to play with all of your new friends. All right, honey, I'm gonna get some more boxes from the car and then make dinner. Are you okay?
I don't feel right. Well, why don't you lie down for a little bit and take a nap?
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him two lips like roses and clover. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. Sandman, I'm so alone. Don't have nobody to call my own. Please turn on your magic beam. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream.
Plus a few drops of his special wetting agent, squirted automatically into the second rinse water. And do you know what this does? It makes it impossible for water to collect in drops on
your surfaces. Cody, why don't you go play outside, okay? I'm about to scrub the floor. Stay near the house where I can see you.
Sparkling clean when it's washed in a hot point.
Turn to the classified pages of your phone book. That's where you'll find your nearest hot point dealer. Or ranges. Refrigerators. Automatic washers and dryers.
Didn't you hear me calling you? What are you doing out here? I told you to stay near the house.
Nothing. I was just... It's a pond.
I don't want you playing near here. It's dangerous.
Plus a few drops of his special wetting agent, squirted automatically into the second rinse water. And do you know what this does? It makes it impossible for water to collect in drops on your dishes. You get spotless dry, even on glasses and silver. Everything is sparkling clean when it's washed in a hot point.
Turn to the classified pages of your phone book.
Don't be afraid. You'll be all right.
Greatest ever. It uses a new system of spotless cleansing.
Mom! Mom!
Two detergent washes plus a few drops of this special...
Mom! Mom!
Cody. What happened?
Mom, there's a monster outside my window.
No, honey. You're just having a bad dream.
No, look, 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 look!
Okay. Let's see here.
No, no monsters out here.
There is a storm out there, though, so maybe that's what scared you, huh?
I know. I was having a bad dream, too.
Is there a monster in it?
Yes, and it was very scary. But I know that you and I are completely safe, like two bugs snug in a rug. Okay?
Get some rest, babe. Go to school tomorrow.
I don't want to go to school.
Well, you have to. Mommy says. Come on, lie down. Lay down. Get some sleep.
Oh, Mom, can you leave the door open?
Office, how may I help you?
May I speak to Dr. Weaver, please?
I'm sorry, ma'am. This is just his answering service. Would you like to leave a message?
No. Thank you.
I don't want to set the world.
Cody! Hurry up! You don't want to be late your first day.
Just want to start a flame in your heart.
Okay. First day of school, here's a little tool. Practice the golden rule, and you'll be Mr. Cool. I love you. Have a great day, okay?
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
So this is your desk. Make yourself comfortable. I'll go get some materials and be back to get started.
Okay, thank you.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Laura.
Jane.
Oh, it's very nice to meet you, Jane.
Where'd you get that dress?
Oh, this?
This is Jane. Yes, sir, right away.
How was your first day?
It was okay.
Did you make any new friends?
No.
Well, I'm sure you will in no time. All right, here we go home. I had a great first day at work. The ladies there are so nice. Kathy and Susan.
Well, I just got such a tickle
out of all of them. Cody, eat your dinner.
I'm not hungry.
Well, try to eat a little.
The troll was twice as big as the biggest billy goat Gruff, but the billy goat was not afraid. He lowered his horns and ran at the troll, pushing him over the bridge. The troll screamed with fury as he fell into the water and was swept away by the current. Then the biggest billy goat Gruff joined his family in the meadow and told them they never had to worry about crossing the bridge again. The end.
Read another one.
Sorry, the time has come for counting sheep for little boys who need their sleep. Now lie down. You've got school tomorrow. You've got to get some rest. Good night, sweet prince.
Leave the door open, okay?
Okay.
Love you.
Hello, Betty? Betty Ferguson?
Yes. Who's this?
Oh, this is Rick Nelson.
Oh, David's brother?
Yeah. Say, what time do you want me to pick you up for the dance Friday night?
Oh, well, 8:30 would just be wonderful.
Yeah, I found her. Okay, I'll be there at 8:30 sharp.
Well, how did you know?
Hello?
What do you mean?
Laura?
I was just going to call you up to ask you to take me. I thought my old hot point dishwasher was wonderful, but this new one is the greatest ever.
It uses a new system of spotless cleansing. Two detergent washes, and a few drops of the special wedding agent squirted automatically into this.
Hello?
Laura.
Mother. Mother, how could you have got my number?
Laura, where have you been?
He just called here. How could you do that?
I didn't give him your number. I only gave it to a few of your friends.
Why? Why would you do that? I told you not to give it to anyone.
They're your friends.
Did you give him my address, too? Is he gonna come here?
He's not going to come there, Laura. He just wants to talk to you. He feels so bad.
I don't care how he feels. I don't know how you could even speak to him after what he did. You're supposed to be on our side. Grandma would be.
Of course we're on your side, Laura.
No, you're not.
Honey, why don't I come and stay with you for a while?
No. No, I don't need any help. Everything's perfect. Wrong.
Mom, there was a monster in my room.
It's okay. It's okay. You're okay.
Mom, the monster from the pond was in my room.
Honey, there's no monster. We were just having a bad dream.
You're not listening to me. It was right here.
It doesn't feel like a dream. I know. But it was. I promise.
The monster was here.
As I yearn to return to you, so will you yearn to return to me. When our paths do cross again, our hearts will entwine with ecstasy.
Laura, I thought you were Mrs. Seaton's ghost.
No, Grandma. She doesn't like it in the attic. I only ever see her in the basement.
Me too.
Where did you find this old thing?
Oh, is he really worth the effort? Oh, honey, don't cry. I can't even imagine how hard it is to be young these days. It was so much simpler back in my time. I wish I could take you back there with me.
I wish you could too.
You'd fit right in.
Thanks, Grandma.
Hi, Francine? It's Laura Butler.
Hi, Laura. We've been trying to reach you. Oh, Dr. Weaver just walked in. Hold on.
Laura, how are you?
Hi, Doctor. I don't know.
What's going on?
Scott called.
You had the pains again?
Yeah. I'm wondering if, maybe I should go back on medication.
You know, I'd prefer we didn't handle him through medication. Can you come in today?
No, I'm out of town.
Where are you? Laura?
I'm here.
Where are you?
You know, I think I'm just being silly. Everything will be fine. Thank you, Doctor.
Laura.
Cody, hurry up! We're gonna be late.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What can I do for you?
Well, I just wanted to let you know that the kitchen sink was leaking, so I turned off the water.
Probably just needs a new seat washer. I'll come by and take a look.
Thank you. And also, the television sort of popped. And now it's not working.
We're not responsible for the television.
Well, now, Lenora, I can go by and take a look at it.
Well, but she's going to have to pay for the parts. The television was left behind. It's not part of the house.
That's okay. If you wouldn't mind just taking a look.
Will do.
Okay. Well, have a nice day.
You as well, young lady.
That's how it starts.
I thought my old hotpoint dishwasher was wonderful, but this new one is the greatest ever. It uses a new system of spotless cleansers. Two detergent washes plus a few drops of this special wetting agent squirted automatically into the second rinse water. And do you know what this does? It makes it impossible for water to collect in drops on your dishes. You get spotless drying, even on glasses and silver. Everything is sparkling clean when it's washed in a hot point.
Turn to the classified pages of your phone book. That's where you find your nearest point dealer. Refrigerators, automatic washers.
Thank you. want to go home.
So I thought maybe you had come by the house for something.
No, probably a raccoon. They climb all over the place. Bunch of pests.
No, I don't think this was a raccoon. My son said that he saw something down by the pond.
He's not supposed to be at the pond. I don't want him playing near there.
Yes, I know. I have, I've already told him to stay away from it.
I can set some traps for the raccoons.
Again, I really don't think it was a raccoon, so I don't think that would be helpful. But I did manage to lock myself out of the house last night when I went to investigate, and,
Wait, that's impossible. The door doesn't lock on its own.
Guess it was stuck.
Well, you need to...
Anyway, I had to break the window on the door to get in, so I'm so sorry.
Well, wait, we already fixed the sink. We're not paying for that window. You broke it.
Of course, I will pay for the window. Anytime you can stop by.
Don't you worry. I'll take care of it.
Ice cream, huh? Cody, why don't you go play?
This looks fun. Kickball? Why don't you go play with them?
They're friends.
Well, this kid's all by himself. He looks like he could use a friend. Why don't you go ask him to play?
He's a dipstick.
Well, maybe you could help him. Be a better person, right? Go on. Go ask him to play. I'll hold your ice cream.
I don't want to.
Go on. Ask him to play.
Let's go.
What happened? He didn't want to play?
No, I told you, let's go.
Cody, did he say something to you?
No, God, forget it, okay?
Cody?
Cody, I know you're not happy here. We are not going back to Mesa, and you know why.
Because you hate Dad?
No, I don't hate Dad. I hate what Dad did to us, and I'm going to make very sure that he can never hurt us again.
Well, I forgive him.
I'm so proud of you for that. But I'm not ready. Maybe someday. In the meantime, can we try to be happy living here? Please. What you drawing?
The pretty lady.
What pretty lady?
From the pond.
I thought you said it was a monster in the pond.
I thought there was a monster in the pond. But then she came to my room and talked to me. Now I understand.
Understand what?
Come here, Mom. Come talk to her. Let's go to the pond.
I don't want to go to the pond.
Well, then I guess she'll just have to come to you.
You know what I would love? I would love it if you would draw me a picture of your school. Or what about a bird? And we could put your drawings up on the fridge. It'll look so nice.
Did you see the pretty lady? Did she talk to you, Mom?
Cody, go to sleep.
I love you, Mom.
Cody, I said lunch was ready.
Okay.
That's enough.
Dude, back.
Cody, Richard Butler. Don't you ever do that again. Cody, why are you so angry at me?
I can't tell you.
Is it about your birthday? I didn't forget.
My birthday?
I was gonna ask you what you wanted to do. Anything but that. Hey, I was thinking, how about we have a party? we can have balloons and ice cream and cake and presents and we can invite your entire class. It'll be a gas. Right?
Okay.
Okay.
I don't mind those people happy. I'm sure our Hot Point refrigerator doesn't mind either. I've never seen anything
hey.
So strong and well.
He looks just like Roy Rogers. You like Roy Rogers, right?
Turn to the classified pages of your phone book. That's where you'll find your nearest Hot Point dealer.
There. Now, there are exactly enough invitations for every kid in your class. So I want you to make sure that everyone gets one, okay?
They won't come.
Of course they will. Everyone loves a party.
Can I invite the pretty lady?
Who?
The pretty lady from the pond.
No. No, you can't.
Why not? She's my best friend. She said that she would take me home.
Cody. This is your home. Okay?
If you would just talk to her, Mom.
Cody, that's enough. Clean up your toys. It's almost bedtime.
She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming around the mountain. She'll be coming around the mountain. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. Here she comes.
Go upstairs, hide in your closet. Do not make a sound.
No, it's okay, Mom. It's okay. Listen to me. Don't be afraid.
Cody, just go.
Thank you.
Cody, are you okay?
It's okay, Mom. She's gone. I'll tell her not to bother you anymore. Okay? You should go to bed. You're tired. I'll stay with you. Okay? We'll be all right. I promise. We're gonna be all right.
You ready?
Now, I want you to give these out as soon as you get to school, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Put them right in here.
Hello. Operator, will you connect me with St. Mary's Church, please? Thank you.
St. Mary's. Sister Agnes speaking.
Hi. I was wondering if there might be someone available to speak with me. I think I have a demon or something in my house. Hello? Hello? Is Mr. Langtree available?
Why? What'd you break this time?
Oh, nothing. I just, I don't know exactly how to say this.
Well, just say it.
Has anyone ever said that there's something wrong with the house?
What are you up to, Missy?
What do you mean?
Because you knew exactly what you were getting into when you moved into the house. So if you think that you can come sashaying in here in that little skirt and caught us in putting a whole bunch of money into that place. My husband might be stupid enough to fall for that, but I'm not.
I'm not trying to do anything.
Well, I don't know what you're doing here in the first place, unless you're hiding something.
I am trying to ask you if there's a ghost in the house.
A ghost? Is it drugs?
No. No, I have a child.
Because if I get wind that any of that crap is going on in that house, I'm going to call the police. And you can be sure of the fact that they'll take your child away from you.
What are we gonna do with all these balloons?
Oh, we're gonna hang them. I'm gonna hang them here, and then along there, and maybe over there. It's gonna look great. Everyone's gonna love it.
It sounds like a garden. You do it, Mom. Love like you will come my way. Ooh, cut the cheese.
Every day seems a little longer. Every way, love's a little stronger. Come what may, do you ever long for true love from me? Every day, it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, 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 hey.
Don't worry, I'm sure they're coming. You know, I bet some of them even got lost. And people love to come late to parties, you'll see. Maybe I should give a few of them a call. I think I have a class list from the school in the kitchen. Be right back. I don't think they're coming, buddy.
I know.
I don't want you to take it personally, okay? We live really far out of town. You know, some people, they can't spend the time driving out here. Okay? But hey, next year, we'll have your party at the malt shop. Or the pizza parlor. That'll be fun. Do you want to open your presents?
Not right now. I think I'm just gonna go upstairs.
You sure?
Okay.
Stop calling here, Scott.
Please don't hang up on me, Laura. Please talk to me.
I've said everything I ever want to say to you.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I miss you. I miss my son.
Well, you better get used to it because you'll never see either one of us ever again. love the way our hot point's designed, too. It could have been made for me. The interior arrangements are all so practical.
Why didn't you hand these out? I spent all that time making a special day for your birthday, and you just sat there. You just sat there and watched me do it. And you didn't even hand out the invitations. Why? Why would you do that? Cody! Cody! No! Cody, come back here! Come back! Cody! Cody! Cody, stop it right now. Now tell me.
Because I wouldn't come. You don't listen to me. You don't listen to anybody.
How would you know that? You didn't even give them a chance.
Because I'm not like them. I hate it here. I want to go home.
Well, we are not going back there. Do you hear me?
Cody. Cody, what? What is wrong with you? Cody. Cody.
Priya, please. I'm so sorry.
Okay. Priya, it's with Mommy.
If you start to feel bad again, you just tell the teacher, okay?
Laura!
I need that new DM-40 on my desk in an hour.
The DM-4 is the most crucial form in the file.
Hey, Cody, how was your day?
It was okay.
Yeah? Cody, have you been teasing those little girls?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Because I can see them tattling on you to a teacher. Do you want to give me your side of the story before I get a call tonight?
I didn't do anything.
All right. I'll wait for the call. Mrs. Langtry?
Oh. Oh, hello. I was just checking on the appliances.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I think you were snooping. Did you find the drugs you were looking for?
You know, this is my house, so I can actually check on it anytime I want.
Not without my permission, you can't. And if you'd like to validate that, we can call the police.
The police?
Mm-hmm.
Is there something wrong with you? because I think there's something terribly wrong going on in this house.
Well, when you figure it out, will you give me a holler? Because I would just love to know.
I want you out of this house. You have 30 days.
Put it in writing.
Oh, I will. 30 days.
I've had repeated complaints about the DM-40 being filed incorrectly or incomplete, not attaching your correspondence to the proper files.
I'll try to get better at that.
It's extremely important that you maintain proper maintenance of the files for the auditors. We're graded on accuracy. There are fines implemented if we don't meet a certain standard.
I understand.
Laura, I have to ask you a personal question.
Have you been drinking? I know you have. I can smell it. We don't tolerate drinking on the job. That's clearly stated in your employee handbook.
Yes, it is. I know, because I read it. But I think that if you had my job, you'd be drinking too. You try leaving your family and your friends and everything you've ever known to move to this small town in the middle of nowhere all by yourself simply because no one gave you any other choice. Then talk to me about drinking on the job.
Laura, look.
Or maybe there's a company manual on how to get rid of a monster. And I'm not talking about my ex-husband or my entire overwhelming situation. No, I am talking about an actual monster who comes into my house in the middle of the night and tries to drag my son out and drown him in a pond out back. I know you think I'm nuts.
No, I don't think that. I think you need help.
I do not need help. I have everything completely under control.
No, you don't. There's no reason we can't help women like you. There's a number there. Call it. Speak to a nurse or a counselor.
Actually, I think you should keep this because I don't want your help and I don't want your miserable job.
Then go.
I'm gone, Daddy-O.
Whoa, look at you, Ginger Rogers.
Your beer is empty. I'm gonna buy you another. Bartender, could he have another, and can I have another one of those?
No, please, you don't buy me a drink.
Oh, come on, I'm celebrating.
Oh, what are we celebrating?
I quit my job today. I hated it, so I quit it.
Atta girl, I like your style. I'll tell you what, I'll get you that drink. If you come dance with me. Come on, one dance. You know this song?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, well, it's old and forgotten. Kind of like me. But you, you're a pretty young thing in a pretty little polka dot dress. You look like an angel. I mean, like I died and went to heaven.
I was an angel once in a play at church. My grandmother made me the most beautiful angel wings. I felt like I could fly in those wings.
Girl like you don't need wings to fly.
No, I have a car.
Well. That'll do. That's pretty good. So what are you gonna do next, Angel?
I don't know. I don't know.
Hey, don't cry. Don't cry. You're gonna figure something out.
I just wish I could go somewhere else. You know, somewhere new. And start fresh. Just start over.
Well, then you go and you dig out those pretty little wings of yours and you fly.
Do you know Claudia Butler? Have you seen Claudia Butler? No?
Cody?
Do you know Cody Butler?
Hey, do you know Cody Butler? Cody? Hey, do you know Cody Butler? No?
How are you today, ma'am?
Officer, I came to pick up my son, and I can't find him anywhere.
Okay, it's all right, ma'am. What's your son's name?
His name is Cody Butler. He's a second grade student. I'm afraid that my ex-husband has taken him without my knowledge.
Okay, well, we're gonna get to the bottom of this, okay? Do you have any identification?
For Cody?
No, ma'am, your identification.
Hi, Laura. I'm Barb Schiff. I'm a caseworker with the department. I'm sorry it took me so long to get here. How are you?
Where is Cody? I went to school to pick him up and he was not there.
No, he wasn't. Where do you think he is?
Does his dad have him?
No, he doesn't.
How do you know? Did you call him?
I didn't need to.
What do you mean?
Would you mind if we backed up a little bit? I think I could be of more help if I understood the details of Cody's accident. I'm referring to the accident last year in Arizona.
Oh. Well, that was nothing. He fell in the pool. I wasn't there. I had to go to the grocery store. His father was watching him. But when I came home, Scott was on the couch watching the game, and I went into the kitchen, and I had this weird feeling like something was wrong, and I was standing at the sink, and I was looking out the window at the pool, and I thought I saw something in it. But when I went out to check, I saw that it was him.
And then what happened?
Well, I dragged him out, and I performed CPR on him until the paramedics came, and then they revived him, and he was completely okay. Why? Are you saying there's something wrong with him because of what happened?
No, that is not what I'm saying. Okay, Laura. You're all right.
I think I need some water.
Okay. You sit tight. I'll get you one.
school.
It's time for me to go home, Mom.
No, no, no. I'm going to take you somewhere else, okay? I'm going to take you away from here. That's what you want, right? We're going to pack up the car, and we're going to go somewhere brand new, and we're going to have a fresh start, okay? Okay?
I don't want to.
Well, you have to, Mommy says. So go upstairs and pack up your stuff.
Cody, where are you going?
No, no, no.
Please, no. Please, let me
upstairs. Go upstairs. Cody, go upstairs.
Let me go.
Cody, no, no. Cody, no.
Stop it.
I'm so sorry. It's not okay.
It will be, you'll see.
Please, Cody, I don't want you to leave me.
You have to let me go, Mom. Please, please.
Thank you.
I can't believe she did this.
The pipe burst.
She broke it, Jim. What's that? Jim, what's that piece of paper? Just hand me.
Just you know why. Why you and I will by and by know true love ways. Sometimes we'll sigh.
All right, that should do it. You're good to go.
Great, thank you.
Where did you say you were headed again?
Home, Mesa.
Oh, it'll make it there.
Sometimes we'll sigh, sometimes we'll cry, and we'll know why. Just you and I know true love ways. Sometimes we'll sigh, sometimes we'll cry, and we'll know why. Just you and I know true.